إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Today is Wednesday and today's date is the 18th of Rabi al-Awwal for the year 1434 of the Hijrah of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam, which coincides with the 30th of January for the year 2013. Wednesday is designated to study our Iman, to study our faith, to study our Aqidah, to study our creed. And lately we have been studying the book of Ar-Riqaq, the book of the things that soften the heart. And the relationship between Iman and the heart is everything. Because if the heart is healthy, everything is healthy. إذا صلح صلح باقي الجسد وإذا فسد فسد باقي الجسد. And if the heart is attached to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything in this life will become very easy. Everything, regardless how hard you have it or how hard you think you have it. If the heart is not attached to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will never experience any rest nor any pleasure in this life. You will be eating dinner and thinking of breakfast at the same time. Yeah? You will be having your salary now and thinking how you are going to receive your salary for the next month without enjoying anything. But once you are attached to Allah and وحدت الله حق التوحيد وعبدت الله وحده لا شريك له, if you believe in Allah's oneness, the true believing, and you worshiped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with nothing in association with Him, you will always be happy. You will always land on your feet in this life and the hereafter. And all goes to what? To the health of the heart. As I told you so many times, physically and physiologically wise, if the heart is healthy, the body is what? In general, healthy. Of course, there could be a damage here and there. But Islamically and religiously, unless the heart is healthy, nothing is healthy. Start with the Tawheed. If you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, or you are associating anything in worshipping Allah or on calling with others other than Allah, or much worse, people, one of the greatest branches of shirk that people do not pay attention is trusting other than Allah. And we fall in this trap all the time. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us our ignorance. We trust the money sometimes more than we trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at your situation when your pocket is what? Going what? You feel very confident. Confident about what? We trust the boss more than we trust Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so on and so forth. So at-tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa haqiqatu at-tawheed. Trusting in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the reality of worshipping Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all this goes to what? To the heart. And one of the things that rottens the heart is wealth. Not because wealth is bad. as we mentioned so many times before we started discussing that, that everything in this life, everything with no exemption, needs money. Everything. Huh? Starting with building this masjid and maintaining this masjid. Huh? You need what? You need the halal money that is sincerely spent for the sake of Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the problem is what? When a person becomes what? The slave of money. Ta'isa abd al-dirham, ta'isa abd al-dinar, ta'isa abd al-qatifa, ta'isa abd al-khamisa. Huh? Miserable is, loser is the slave of dinar, the slave of dirham, the slave of this garment or that garment. Wallahi, before I came to this country, and met Muslims who go about the fashion and imitating the kuffar, this hadith was difficult for me what? To understand how a person can be a slave of a garment, a slave of a pants, a slave of a shirt. Then we find it what? Oh, yes. Yes. Anything they do, the kuffar suddenly becomes what? Today they wear something new. Oh, it's shame to wear something what? Old. They wear something old and ragged. Tomorrow we'll what? We'll wear something old and ragged, and we pay what? $300-$400 for a pants that has 6-7 holes. Six, seven holes. 1906 became the fashion that the best furniture is the furniture that you pick up from the dumpster. Literally, I'm not joking. And everybody was bragging how dirty his couch is. How dirty, and I'm not talking, it looks dirty. It appears to be dirty. Dirty, filthy, stinky, smelly, awful. لو دخلوا جحر دب دخلتم وراءهم. If they go inside a lizard's hole, you will go what? After them. So wealth is good. Who is bad? The person who deals with what? With this wealth. And when we start this series, we told you that the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam summarized it in a most wonderful phrase. He said what? نِعْمَ الْمَالَ الصَّالِحِ لِلْرَجُلُ الصَّالِحِ. What a wonderful thing. The righteous, look at the expression. The righteous money for the righteous what? Person. That's the criteria. So now we're going to go and visit the hadith of Abu Dharr radiyallahu anhu, which we told you that Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, back to back, he mentioned this hadith under the title بَابُ الْمُكْثِرُونَ هُمُ الْأَقَلُّونَ وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتَهَا. And immediately after that, he mentioned it outer what? قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما يسرني أن عندي مثل أحد هذا ذهبا. Subtitle, chapter, those who have most wealth in this life, will have what? Will be the least. And one narration what? هم الأسفلون. Will be what? The lowest of the low in the hereafter, except those who spend in the cause of Allah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying what? It does not make me happy to have gold equal to this mountain of Uhud. And we're going to see that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? Unless I am in what? Saving it to pay a loan. Then we stopped at when Abu Bakr, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said the following. فَمَشَيْتُ مَعَ رَسُولِ مَعَهُ أي مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ساعة فقال لي اجلس هاهنا. Then I walked for another while with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then he told me sit here. قال فأجلسني في قاع حوله حجارة فقال لي اجلس هاهنا حتى أرجع إليك. And he said what? He made me sit on a floor which is surrounded by some rocks or stones, on a ground that is surrounded by some stones. And he told me, keep sitting here until I come back to you. قال فانطلق في الحرة. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went walking in الحرة. الحرة is the name of an area which have volcanic rocks. Okay? حتى لا أراه, and he disappeared where I could not see him anymore. فلبث عني فأطال اللبثة. And he what? He stayed for long, and I became what? Worried about him. ثم إني سمعته وهو مقبل وهو يقول وإن سرق وإن زنى. Then I heard him while he was coming back, and I heard him saying, even if he steals, or even and even if he commits adultery. فلما جاء لم أصبر حتى قلت. And when he came back to me, I could not control myself. I could not be patient for him to tell me the story. So I initiated the question. يا نبي الله جعلني الله فداك من تكلم في جانب الحرة. He said, oh Allah's Prophet, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ransom me for your safety. Who you were talking in that area of Al-Harra? ما سمعت أحدا يرجع إليك شيئا. I did not hear anyone exchanging the talk with you. I only heard you what? Talking. قال ذلك جبريل عرض لي في جانب الحراء. That was Jibreel who met me in the side of الحراء. قال أي جبريل عليه السلام وعلى رسولنا الصلاة والسلام, بشر أمتك أنه من مات لا يشرك بالله شيئا دخل الجنة. He said, give this good news to your ummah, to your nation, that anyone of them who dies while not associating anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will enter al-Jannah. And this is what? In agreement of the two statements in Surah An-Nisa, where Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala said what? Inna Allah la yushir, inna Allah la yaghfiru an yushraka bihi wa yaghfiru ma duna thalika لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah does not forgive associating partners with him, and less than that, anything less than shirk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives whom he wills. That means the Muslim who says أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and does not commit a sin that makes him a kafir. If he commits anything other than that, and he does without repenting to Allah al-Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has a chance for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him his sin. Or if he does not forgive him his sin and send him to serve his sentence and punishment in Jahannam, after he serves his sentence and punishment, eventually he will what? Will come out and go to where? To Al-Jannah. And we explained this in full details when we studied what? For 10 years, Al-Aqidah Al-Tahawiyyah. So, Jibreel said what? Came to him, said, well, give this good news to your ummah. Anyone who dies, while not associating partner with Allah Al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will what? He will go to Al-Jannah. Mashi? قلت يا جبريل وإن سرق وزنى. I said, oh Jibreel, even if he steals and commits adultery. قال نعم. And Jibreel said what? In affirmation. Yes. قال قلت وإن سرق وإن زنى. I said, even if he steals and commits adultery. قال نعم. قلت وإن سرق وإن زنا. Again, said, even if he steals and commits adultery. And he said, what? Yes. قال yes. So this is the hadith that that Jibreel talked with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second hadith, which is the same one, and then under the title which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, what? It does not please me to have gold equal to this mountain of Uhud. The hadith reads what? قال أبو ذر كنت أمشي مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حرة المدينة فاستقبلنا أحد فقال يا أبا ذر قلت لبيك يا رسول الله قال ما يسرني أن عندي مثل أحد هذا ذهبا تمضي علي ثالثة وعندي منه دينار إلا شيئا أرصده لدين إلا أن أقول به في عباد الله هكذا وهكذا عن يمينه وعن شماله ومن خلفه ثم مشى ثم قال إن الأكثرين هم المقلون يوم القيامة إلا من قال هكذا وهكذا عن يمينه وعن شماله ومن خلفه وقليل ما هم. Yeah. Then the rest of the hadith is the same as we what just finished reading. Yeah. Says that Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he said, while I was walking with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the Harra of Al-Madina, we faced Uhud. And Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu said, oh Abu Dharr, I said at your disposal, ya Rasulullah. Qal, he said, it does not please me that I have gold equal to this mountain of Uhud. And it does not please me to stay with me even for 3 nights while I'll have even one dinar. Except the portion that I save to pay my what? My debt. Because you cannot give any charity. You cannot perform any ibadah if your debt is what? Due for payment. And the key word is what? Due for payment. Before you give to any charity, you have what? To pay your due what? Debt. Before you go to Hajj, before you do anything, you have to pay your what? Due debt. You cannot spend people's what? Money. لو كنت لو كنت حقا محسنا لم تكن لو لم تكن لو لو كنت من أهل المكارم لم تكن من جيب غيرك محسنا يا بلفرو. If you are a person of charity, then you will not be spending what? The money from the pockets of the others. And Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu used to say this a lot. يحب الخمر من مال الندامة ويكره أن تفارقه الفلوس. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu said what? يحب الخمر من مال الندامة ويكره أن تفارقه الفلوس. He said, well, he likes to drink khamr as long as what others are what are paying for it, and he hates his money to depart what to depart him. When you are in debt and your debt is due, you cannot spend one penny in any cause unless you pay it back or you ask the permission of what of the creditor. The person who loaned you the money. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? Even if I have gold as much as as the mountain of Uhud. I would not like to even to stay with me for nights, not even one single dinar, except the portion what? Yeah? That I keep it to pay what? Save it to pay my these things. I love for this money to do with what? To throw it what? This way. And this way, referring what? And then he said what? To his right, to his left, in front of him, and in his back. And he said what? Those who have wealth most in this life were going to have the least in the day of judgment, except for those who what? Do with what? With their money to their right, to their left, in front of them, and to their back. As we said last week, you have more, Allah blessed you with more, Allah entrusted you with more, you have to what? To spend based on the portion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a general rule in the Quran al-Kareem. Yeah? Remember, we always told you, there is no how much. Yeah? There is no how much in spending in the Sharia. There is what? How much I can afford. Yeah? There is no how much I can spend. How much I can afford. And wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to ask you, even if it's a fraction of penny that you can afford to spend, don't underestimate it. Don't underestimate it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? اتَّقِ اللَّهَ اتَّقِ النَّارَ وَلَوْ إِيشْ بِشِقِّ تَمْرَ. Save yourself from the hellfire, even if you pay what? Half of the debt. And you remember the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha. When a lady, a poor lady, came knocking at her door with two little girls. She's asking for help. And Aisha said, when I went inside, I could not find anything except what? One date. One date. I handed it over to her. And she said what? The lady, radiallahu anha, took it, split it into two pieces, two halves, and she gave what? One half to this little girl, and one half to that little girl. In your mind, you said, well, what's one day is going to happen? Well, one day is better than nothing. What is one penny is going to happen? One penny is what? Is better than nothing. Most important, let it come out of your heart. Let it come out of your heart. Irhamukallah. Before it comes from what? From your pocket. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless it. Subhanakallah wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. If you have any questions, corrections, or other concerns, we'll entertain them in the remaining time. Otherwise, jazakumullah khairan for coming. And jazakumullah khairan for listening. Yes, Hajj.
I think we talked about this last time. So spending also, it could mean spending on your family. It could be included with that spending also for somebody who has money. That's included, right?
Your family has to come first. Always your family. You have to satisfy the need of your family first.
So basically, you shouldn't be storing money. Is that kind of the point of that?
No, you can store money. We need to store money. Right. Because not storing money, in some cases, going to be what? What's considered? Israf, waste. Yes, we need. But when the need arises, you cannot store one single penny. You understand? When the need arises, you cannot store one single penny. Your child needs an operation. Say, let him die or save the $40,000. No, which one? Let me choose. I'll save the $38,000. You save them and you save for self a good piece of Jahannam. You understand, Habib? I'm giving the example of a child. So you will understand that it extends to wherever there is a need. That's why, quickly, listen carefully. لما العلماء تكلموا على أحكام الصدقات على أحكام النفقة الفرض قالوا النفقة المنصوص عليها والنفقة الطارئة. When the ulama spoke about the obligatory spending. They say we have the part which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us precisely in the Quran al-Kareem and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there is a text to tell us about that. And they said the emergency spending. What's the emergency spending? Now, you just paid your zakah and you saw a person in the street, yeah, starving to death, yeah, being so exaggerated. Say, well, I just paid my zakah. I do not have to help this person with food or for anything. Doesn't work. Yeah? That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what? لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ بَاتَ شَبْعَانَ وَجَارُهُ جَاءَ. It is not one of us. The one who goes to sleep full while knowing that his what? His neighbor is what? Is hungry. Yeah? So that is the case. Okay? Done? Jazakumullah khair. Anybody wants to close this for me? Close this. Jazakumullah khair.